of attention is the sustained attention. All these things like sit, stand, or you'd be like, if I say the color red, you would stand. If I say blue, you would sit, hands up, hands down. All those things where there is movement of the body happening. Brain gym activities are also sometimes used. So that way they help them to be focused and come into their actual activity that they were supposed to do. So these physical movement activities can be of help. Engaging the child in physical activities like walking on totems, or you know what I tell with these ADHD children, is walk as slow as you can. What usually happens is that since their attention is flattening, they're always in a hurry also sometimes. So you tell them that I want you to focus and look on the line that you're following, or you could draw pathways. You have those colored tapes, right? So what we used to do in the ground, we used to put them in the zigzag manner. We ask them to walk on it, or with a chalk, you can ask them to draw it. You draw any random manner and ask them to walk on it. S, 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 or zigzag, 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 curved lines. Or I draw two lines and ask them to walk in between it as slowly as you can. That activity also helps build their attention. You can ask them to do push-up against the wall as well. And then there are times, you know, you could also give them fidgets to concentrate better. There was a trend of fidget spinners that had come. So actually fidget spinners were invented for children and adults with ADHD to be able to focus better. Though it became a play activity for everybody, but as per research, fidget spinners had come for children with ADHD so that they could improve their attention ability. So these are the activities that you could have, and this is the ability resource, that is the attention span workbook. Again, has a lot of activities for you all to pick up and do it with children. Again, remember, the trick is to be consistent while doing these activities. You can pick up and do any activity, but it needs to be done on a daily basis for at least 2 to 3 minutes so that your child is getting the hang of it. Today the child would put in 2 minutes to do it, tomorrow 3, 4, and once this has developed, you could see that generalizing in their academic skills as well. So this is how you could build attention in children and take it forward with them.